noise canceling. To think I've gone to all this trouble just to lose my looks and mind, too much that I am real, only to myself. No matter, even heaven goes to hell in time and time. Yet in the revision of the future, I am still here, speaking my mind, unminding my mouth, preaching to a mountain whose only sound is my moan, gliding down it, where water once carried, on and on, amusing wasted gods in ways we humans never could. Amass delight, weigh your words until they're free. Babble, bubble, treble, try. When the noise is finally gone, what will miss it? I unwind myself at my mother's feet, touch a match to the hem of her emerald M and make it an ember as another sound learns what sleep really is. She too adored ideas of continuance, cultivated songs that helped her breathe. But now she is winded, now wounded, now new. And my math is bad, my science reduced to a sigh. How dare you disturb the universe, a child says. How right you are, I say. All this singing about what's collapsing has grown older than I'll ever be. No matter, no muttering over spilled blood and milk and tea. Though I dream of orchards no one can discard, though I stare towards stars starved of distances to defy. Yes, the world minds me, or I mind the world. The few places in it I've touched, its winds that plague me as harp music might, and so I harp. You act like it's my fault, youth went elsewhere. I'm tired of watching my mouth, my head feels like an egg no one warms with their waiting. Even to sleep is humiliating, etc. But when the grief is gone, what will miss me? No matter. Everyone dares a door to close on splendor, I am told, as I extol the sun for beating me at my own name, for numbing this plenum that casts its small adorations on times out of mind, my mind, my... Say I'm sitting on the floor in the children's section of a library July set on fire, and the blaze is not near so guttural as anyone guessed. All I ask is you warm your hands over the folk tales adorning the night, the clockmaker and his stolen eyes rising from the page. Or all I ask is that you scatter me where Babylon once was, for I mind my mythic data from tangled tongues and trees and deities. No matter, no master watches this dream verse itself in gravity. No mystery eavesdrops here, though a stream converses so fluently with the stones it smooths. I can hear it, every word, and it's vanishing and speaking of banishment. Should I leave my belongings to the desert? Should we say so long and mean so very long? As for the song my mother sung to herself, may you never hear the end of it. Which is to say, please forgive the tunes I can no longer carry into the future, and please forgive the fortune tellers their crumbling bones, for they are thrown as no voice, and no, inside us is our beating.